It's not business class. ANA calls this the room. Welcome on board 14 hours of pure luxury in a massive suite inspired by Japan.
Hello, Jet Setters. I'm Jeb Brooks from GreenerGrass.com. This is ANA Business Class, and you're coming along.
Here's the plan. We'll leave New York's JFK at about 1 o'clock this afternoon and fly for around 14 hours, crossing more than 6,700 miles before touching down just before 6 o'clock tomorrow evening. So let's get this trip started at JFK Airport.
This is my first time in Terminal 7 here, and I think we can agree it's seen better days. JFK is undergoing a similar renovation to what we've seen over at LaGuardia, and I think that's a good thing. New York's airports, it was time for an upgrade, and it's happening. Terminal 7 here at JFK used to be the home of British Airways, and if you look carefully, you can spot some evidence of that that remains. But today, airlines like ANA operate out of here. Now, we're super early, so it's not time to check in yet. We gotta kill a little time before we can do that. So then we're gonna take a ride on the old air train and just kind of explore JFK a little bit.
And our ride on the air train offered us the best view we'd get all day of the ANA 777-300 that was gonna take us on this journey across the Pacific Ocean. Japan Airlines also serves this route, but they operate from Terminal 8. Which of these two Japanese carriers is your favorite, ANA or JAL? Let me know in the comments below. Progress is being made on Terminal 6, which will eventually be the home of JetBlue, among others. And back at Terminal 7, it was time to check in.
ANA has two flights daily from JFK to Haneda. We're in the 1 p.m. Sounds a lot better than me till 1 a.m. We'll have daylight almost the whole time.
This is my first time flying with ANA, and I love flying the airline from the country where I'm going. When I'm going there, it really gets me in the mood. Speaking of, it's time to check in, so let's get it done. Not this time.
ANA is one of a handful of airlines that still have a separate first class cabin. Are you bummed not to be in that cabin today, Jeb?
Yeah, I mean, I hate to say it. I would love to be up there, but I'm super excited about the business class. I understand it's spectacular. I'm sure we will not have anything to complain about. It'll be good no matter what.
Business class looks incredible, and maybe someday we'll find ourselves on board an ANA first class flight. What do you think? Do you guys want to see that? Let us know.
Please? That's check-in complete. Next stop, Japan. ANA passengers use the Horizons Business Class Lounge here in Terminal 7. But before we check that out, we thought we'd explore the terminal a little bit more. Most importantly, see if we can check out our airplane. I think there's officially no view of this 777 to Tokyo Haneda, which is really disappointing. Maybe if we sneak around this corner. Great view of the Aerolíneas Argentinas A330, but no 777 for us. That's too bad. Hey, let's check out the lounge.
Let's do it.
In addition to ANA, this lounge gets used by passengers who are flying on Condor, Kuwait, Iceland Air, LOT, and Ethiopian, so I guess it can get pretty busy, though we're here fairly early and it's not. There are some passengers who are flying Iceland Air's earlier flight into Keflavik right now, but other than that, it seems to just be ANA passengers. We'll be here for a little while, so maybe we'll be able to sample the food there and maybe even try a drink before we head out to the plane.
But time flies when you're having fun. Before we knew it, it was time to leave.
ANA operates 15 777-300s, but not all of them have the configuration we're about to see. There are only 9 that have this sort of new version. This business class seat is so special that ANA have dubbed it the room. But let's get on board and find out together whether this is the best business class in the sky. Next stop, Tokyo.
Once on board, we'll turn to the right. I'm in seat 11K, Suzanne in 13. Now these odd-numbered seats, they're closer to the window, and they do face backwards. My first impression of this seat is solid. The wide seat itself is impressive, with enough room for two people to comfortably sit next to each other in flight. There is, of course, lots of bedding and an amenity kit to explore later. The size of the screen is truly impressive too, and it's going to be easy to enjoy such a massive TV on this long-haul flight. This narrow cabinet will be a good spot to store my water bottle in flight. And the tray table? Well, it's large and sturdy enough for what I'm sure is going to be impressive catering from ANA.
First things first, this thing is huge.
This seat is massive. We could both sit here.
Yeah, the whole flight and like totally comfortable. There's a reason they call it the room, and I think we've just discovered what that is. It's massive.
Amazing space. This is going to be an amazing flight.
Yeah, what is it, like 14 hours and change?
Not long enough in my book.
Not mad about that.
Suzanne made her way back to her seat. Flight attendants offered a pre-departure beverage, and we pushed back. Boarding seemed to take no time at all. We'll cross through an incredible 14 time zones on this trip. Departing JFK on a beautiful, clear day like this is always a magical experience, and today was no exception. The in-flight entertainment, which can be controlled by remote control, is again presented on a massive screen. Unfortunately, there aren't that many choices. That said, the moving map and camera features were great. Wi-Fi was also available for purchase. The entire flight cost about $22. It wasn't that fast, but it did the trick for a 14-hour trip. As always, please never mistake criticism for complaints on this channel. We just want to give you a sense of what you might experience if you choose to take a flight like this.
Definitely just looking at the basics of this amenity kit, but they're the good basics, and I'm happy to have all of them. I think pretty much everything's going to get used on this trip. With about 13 and a half hours between here and Tokyo, it's time to settle in, maybe turn on a movie, just enjoy the views. I don't know, but plenty of time to enjoy everything in this massive business class room.
Service began about 20 minutes after departure with this refreshing towel.
These headphones could be so much better. They feel kind of chintzy, and they do a very good job of keeping the aircraft sounding so. OG subscribers will know I'm a stickler for my headphones. If you're traveling with ANA, I recommend bringing your own. I did bring my headphones. My Bose QC20s, thank goodness. These are game changers. Unfortunately, I stopped making them, so I'm grateful to have this last pair. These things go. I'm done.
A flight attendant brought the menu card. Head to greenergrass.com/menus to see even more of it. First up, an amuse-bouche. And the duck and cheese canapé was really good.
And naturally, perfect timing. Absolutely perfect timing. They just broke my QC20s and just broke. So I'll be using the ones ANA provides for the rest of this trip.
And how could I not have the Japanese option when it came to dining on ANA? Everything on this plate was so good. Each bite was a surprise and a flavorful combination that really made me feel like I was already in Japan. I loved this dinner.
This food is so good. There's no way I could have chosen the Western option. I had to go Japanese as I was making my way to Tokyo. And it was so good. I mean, this is just the start. Every single bite was delicious and memorable and really tasty. Great job of catering out of JFK. Very impressive.
About 2 hours after takeoff, my main course arrived. It was Greenland halibut in ginger sauce, and it was so good. It was steamed rice and miso soup, but I have to say, the pickled Japanese vegetables might have been my favorite. Suzanne wrapped up with cheesecake and herbal tea.
Now, typically, my golden rule on a plane is never order the fish. But, however, the transportation on this flight has been delicious. Do you think so?
Yeah, all of it. It's been really good. And I thought the particularly the main course that was in halibut.
Halibut.
With the ginger soda sauce was amazing. Like the flavors on planes are typically pretty aggressive. These have been subtle and like really delicious.
Super delicious. Fish on a plane, I'm a convert.
By this point, we were over Canada, and having the moving map appear on the remote control while I watched a movie on the main screen made it easy to keep track of our progress. ANA's 777-300s have 212 seats, and in this configuration, there are 116 economy seats, 24 premium economy seats, 64 business class seats like ours, and 8 incredible first class seats. We caught a glimpse of them on our way off the plane later in this flight in Tokyo. Suzanne decided it was time to set up her bed, so she pulled out the slippers and went to work setting it up. Turns out putting this thing together is a bit of a puzzle, but she finally worked it out. ANA provides passengers with a mattress pad and a blanket, as well as two pillows. One of them's memory foam. It's great. Back in my own room, I raised my partition, closed my door, and settled into my own bed.
Well, Suzanne is down for a nap, but that means I'll be the same. And I've got to tell you, I think where it really excels is just how much space there is once in bed. There's nothing like this in the sky in terms of shoulder room. I mean, it goes on for days. On either side of my shoulders, it's a bit narrow, but no more so than pretty much any other business class seat that I've experienced. So this is super comfortable.
I woke up about 2 hours later, somewhere over Alaska.
It was about 2 hours of good solid sleep, and I'm feeling pretty good. I don't want to sleep too much because I want to adjust a little bit when we arrive in the evening in Japan as best I can. So I can get up and just maybe watch some more of this movie. Kind of hang around the room for the next 7-8 hours until we touch down.
So I ordered a cup of coffee and enjoyed the in-flight entertainment. A few hours later, I went for a mid-flight snack. In my case, I chose the corn soup. It wasn't very filling, but it was very delicious. There were several other options available for mid-flight snacks. I was sorry the rice bowl was not available on our flight, though. About 2 hours before landing, service began again with another refreshing towel. This time, I thought it was only fair to try the Western option. Unfortunately, the spinach cannelloni was not as good as the Japanese option. I wish I'd gone the other way, but I'm glad I tried it. And now it's time for the Jeb score. By using this unscientific measure, you'll get a sense of what I think about this singular flight. We'll rate the lounge, the seat, the food, the in-flight entertainment, and the service. First, the lounge in Terminal 7 was mediocre. The food was lacking, but there was plenty of seating. There were no views, and the bathrooms were dirty, but it was nice to have a place to get away from the hustle and bustle downstairs. 3 stars here. The seat is one of the best business class seats out there. Everyone raves about the Q suite at Qatar, but this is just as good, maybe even better. 5 stars here. When it comes to food, it's no surprise the Japanese option was better than the Western one, but I'm sorry they weren't equivalent. I feel like they should have been. That means 4 stars here. The in-flight entertainment screen was incredible, so big, so bright, so clear. I just wish they'd had more options. 4 stars here. Finally, the service was fantastic. At one point, Suzanne ordered some herbal tea, and it took the crew some time to make it. When they delivered it, they were so apologetic for the delay. At every turn, they were professional, courteous, and just so very kind. 5 stars for them. Before we total that up, let's talk price. we often book one-way tickets, which can be more expensive. In this case, a flight from JFK to Tokyo was around $8,000 when we needed to take the trip, but we paid less than $3,000 each. Now, still a lot of money, of course, but how did we find that savings? Well, we started our day in Toronto. We found that one-way tickets from Canada through the U.S. are often cheaper. Granted, our need for one-way tickets is somewhat unusual, but the hack has saved us a bundle. Now, all in, ANA earned 21 out of a possible 25 stars.
Between now and the next time, see you in the sky. I love flying an airline or a nation's flag. No, I don't want to say that because that's not true.
Do you think this will be like okay if I clip it here or is it not close enough?
We're about to find out.
Okay, we're about to find out.
ANA uses the Horizons bit. No, that's not right.
This is a sham. Hot take. International Delight is no delight at all.